Hello, I hope this short video starts you thinking about how you might use text analysis in your research. The library is here to help. Text analysis is a subset of data mining, taking advantage of the wealth of content that has been brought online through digitization or direct writing for the web. It is the process of using computational methods such as computer algorithms to find insights and trends. It can be done on a large body of structured or unstructured text. Unstructured meaning not in a spreadsheet or database. It is part of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and natural language processing, NLP. NLP is using non-natural computer programming languages like Python to run algorithms on natural languages such as English, French, or Chinese. It can be very complicated or quite simple. Also, keep in mind, text analysis is an additional research method that is not done alone. It can allow for a shift in the researcher's perspective and make it possible to ask new or different questions not possible by a close reading. Text analysis is more than just searching for keywords in a text or receiving results from a database. It is also seeing relations and connections between keywords, looking for patterns in the text or networks that a list of keyword results do not reveal. It can often involve change over time, pattern recognition, or comparative analysis. A couple of terms which you will come across when trying to understand text analysis. As mentioned, NLP. This is a very common method using Python to analyze text. The NLP toolkit is a great place to start with simple instructions. Various terms are used to describe the concept of a word in text analysis. You will see the terms n-gram or unigrams, bigrams, and trigrams to describe a single word or phrase such as vegetable, vegetable stock, or chicken noodle soup. Tokens is yet another term that means word and is often used in conjunction with a bag of words, where order of words or tokens and sentence and paragraph structure are stripped away as the algorithm runs through the text. This happens with word frequency algorithms, but sentence and paragraph order can remain for other algorithms. It depends on your research question and how you set up the code. Distant reading is also a term used often because it is the opposite of reading each text closely. You may hear the phrase non-consumptive research. Non-consumptive research is not consuming or not closely reading each and every document. There are two reasons why we may not be able to read or consume each document closely. One, the content is so large, i.e. 800,000 documents, we couldn't possibly read it all. Or two, it is in copyright and we aren't allowed to access it all, like from a vendor such as ProQuest, which sells us access to their data. Non-consumptive research is possible because computers do some of the work by reading and processing the text through algorithms and computational methods that the scholar has designed and initiates. Once run, the computer outputs the results or insights for the scholar. We ask the computer questions and it spits out the answers about the documents or corpora. Following are several methods. Word frequency is the easiest and most common and a great place to start. You can look at word frequency across one text or an entire body of text. You can remove words called stop words such as the and of to unearth more pertinent terms to the content. Next, you can weight those words or terms using TF, IDF and find the significant terms in the text. Using collocation or concordance code, you can see how words connect in a text and what words are used together. Topic modeling is understanding all the topics that are included in a large body of material. What topics did this person write about in their diaries? Or what are the general topics in this genre of text? Sentiment analysis is using a dictionary to map emotions in the text. Are the authors or subjects happy or angry? That is just the beginning. Please see the U of SC workshops and the second tutorial in this series for more information. Or do reach out to me at the address on the screen. Thank you for your time.